गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ इंग्लिश. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हियर. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ यू, आई एम गोइंग टू डील विथ यू राइटिंग स्किल. यू नो चिल्ड्रन, राइटिंग स्किल इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन योर 10th स्टैंडर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. दैट अकाउंट्स फॉर 35 मार्क्स टुगेदर. इफ यू कैन राइट ऑन योर ओन एंड इफ यू कैन राइट करेक्ट एंड सिंपल इंग्लिश, so you can score maximum marks. Normally it is said, it is a common assumption that we cannot score 80 out of 80 marks in English. So to break that myth, here we are going to discuss certain things. We can score 80 out of 80 marks provided we should not commit certain silly mistakes and smaller mistakes. So out of entire syllabus, today I am going to discuss about writing skill. And in writing skill, I am going to tell you about letter writing. See children, letter writing, you have 5 marks for letter writing in examination. And time approximately given 12 minutes in the examination. And you have to write a letter in the examination in 12 minutes only. And in that 12 minutes, we have to manage and take care of every tit and bit particularities about letter writing. If we commit any mistakes, so we cannot expect, we cannot hope to score 5 out of 5 marks. See, our target should be scoring 5 out of 5 marks, and we can score it if we follow certain rules. So before going ahead, let me tell you the division of this letter writing. Particularly, namely, this letter writing is divided into 2 categories. Both the genres, both the types are asked in examination. You are given option, either you go for formal letter or you can go for informal letter. So here, personal letter and impersonal letter. Personal letter can also be further divided into 2 categories, that is general letter and second condolence letter. General letter means there you ask, you write a letter to your friend, your mother, your colleague, your relatives, and you can discuss a general topic. But when it comes to condolence letter, there you are writing letter to console somebody, to soothe somebody on any loss like death or any bigger damage. Now we go to formal letter. Formal letter is namely classified into these categories. There is a form, impersonal letter, there is a formal letter, there is a placing an order letter. So each letter has a different way of writing. There is a letter to editor, special one. Job application, normally you do not have job application. That is asked in 12th standard, so you need not worry for that. But in formal letter, you may have placing an order. You may have letter to editor, that is commonly asked question. And there is a leave application as well. These are the categories of writing letter. So now we are going to see this especially, because we cannot discuss all, so we'll discuss this formal letter. Well, we'll see how to write it and what precautions we have to take while writing this formal letter. So let's go ahead. So here is a formal letter. This letter is especially written to the officials. Here is a definition of formal letter. A letter that is not written to your friends, parents and relatives, but to the officials like principal, corporator, mayor, commissioner, proprietor and etc. etc. So when we are not writing letter to our friends, parents and relatives, that is called as formal letter. So each letter must have a format. So now we will discuss about the format of the letter. So friends, here is the format of formal letter. See, each letter has their own way of writing. When you write personal letter, it has a different format. Format is your layout, that's your blueprint. If you know the format, that's your map. If you know the map, you can exactly know what is to be written and where. So here we see, first is sender's address. And here, according to new rules and new permissions, everything is to be written to your right side. Earlier, the structure was a little different.
sender's address would be at right side and the receiver's address would be at the left side. But here the things have changed. Now everything will be according to CBSE pattern. Now the pattern has been same. So this is sender's address. Normally this is given. I'll tell you detail about what precautions we have to take while writing sender's address. Then there is addressee. Addressee means the one whom you are writing address. There also what precautions we have to take, I'll tell you in detail. Now there is subject. Subject, one thing you have to remember about writing subject, that subject has to come in one line only. It should not go in another line, otherwise it appears very shabby. Now opening salutation. So here either sir or madam, that also I'll tell you what precautions we have to take, what particularities we have to maintain, what rituals we have to follow. Now there is opening line, there is main body, there is closing line, and this closing salutation, thanking you, yours, whatever it is, sincerely, faithfully, obediently, that I'll tell you when to write and what. And then here you can write your name or even email address, or even if you can write XYZ, that will also be accepted. So now I'll elaborate each thing in detail. Okay, fine, let's go ahead. Okay, so children, let's see how we can write the sender's address. Now I'll explain you in detail here. Here I'll tell you what precaution we have to take while writing sender's address. Normally this sender's address is already given in your question paper. But in case you don't have sender's address, so you should have your own sender's address. It does not mean that you should write your own original address. You should have any dummy or any imaginary address ready with you. But there we have to take certain precautions. Now here I give you one address. Let us see. You can have same address. Here is one address. Samarth Nagar, Samarth Marg, Raman Nagar, Nagpur, full stop and date. Here is a date. About date also I'll tell you. Naturally 20. Now here I tell you something, particular things about writing address, and this applies everywhere, remember that. That is applicable everywhere. Here we see what precautions we have to take while writing sender's address. As I told you, sender's address may be given in the examination. When the sender's address is given, you can use the same address. But if you don't have address, sender's address in your examination paper, that time you should be ready with any imaginary address. Now this address I have written, that I had prepared already. On the 11th hour, I did not think about each line. That kills your time, that consumes your time. Remember children, you have only 12 minutes in the examination to write an effective letter. Even if somebody asks me to write letter in 12 minutes, it's not possible for me to write letter in 12 minutes and that effective one. We have to think, but here you can keep certain things ready-made. As you can see here, your letter should contain not more than 5 lines, including date line. Remember that. As you can see, first line, second line, third line and fourth line is about city. What precaution, what particularly prominently we see here is that each line separated by comma. Nowadays either you give comma or not, that hardly matters. But if you are giving punctuation marks in address, so each line should be given punctuation marks properly. Clear? So you can give punctuation marks or not give, that hardly matters. But I would like to suggest, instead of being dragged,
into controversy, better you should go with giving punctuation marks. Here you see, Vaikunth Vihar, each letter of each word is written in capital. Then there is comma at the end of each line. In second line, it is about Marg, Samarth Marg, S capital, M capital, then again there is comma. Then Ramnagar, third line, then comma. Then Nagpur, you should write Nagpur only. That is my suggestion. There is no rule which city should we write. There is no rule as such. But I suggest you that you should go with Nagpur only. Only Nagpur should be written. Clear?
So children, now we will talk about sender's address. Normally, sender's address has been given in your question paper. But in case you do not have sender's address in your question paper, you should be ready with one sender's address already. That should be with you. Already you prepare one address of your own. You need not write your original address. Normally, our real addresses are not that effective and that enchanting. So here is address, and this also I have prepared for you. This is not my address. So you can see the first line. First line of this address, you can see here, each letter of each word is written in capital. As you can see here, V is capital, then there is comma. Second line about Marg, Rasta, Road, that also S is capital, M is capital, at the end of that line there is comma. Third line about Nagar or area, Raman Nagar, so here you see at the end of that line also there is comma. Then the fourth line should be the city line. You can write name of your city, and after that you can write pin code. It is not necessary that you should write correct pin code, but if you write correct pin code, that will be effective work. See, your address should not have more than four lines, because that appears very unproportional. It does not appear proportional, that does not appear suitable. If you are writing your sender's address of around seven lines, that looks very huge and shabby and irrelevant. So remember that there is no rule as such, but that's my personal advice, that you should write your address only in four lines. Clear? And what precaution, what particularly we notice here, that at the end of city there is full stop. After that you write date. As you can see here, date. After date you should not write any punctuation mark that you remember, not only in examination but also in your life also. You should remember that after date you should not place full stop. There are ways of writing date also. This is one of the ways of writing date. As you can see here, this you can write date this way also, March 7, 2020. This is also one of the ways of writing letter address. Remember, what particularly we notice here, when we write date in this manner, so that time you use here TH. When you write the day first and then the month, month should not be written. Complete spelling of month should not be written when you are following this pattern. As you can see here, day, then month, only three letters of the month, and then year, and after that there is no full stop. You can follow this pattern also. Here you see, first March, complete spelling of month. Avoid writing September, October, February. There is possibility of committing mistake, so go with March. Why March? Because you know, your examination comes in the month of March. And normally your paper is on, roughly it is my calculation, it is something around 6754 of March. So remember this date, that will help you. Remember that smaller things are, smaller changes are making bigger differences in the examination. So children, when you think about scoring 5 out of 5 marks in letter writing, you have to be very, very careful about each smaller details. As you can see, one more thing I want to tell you, never write your date like this, 7, 3, 20, this is a wrong way of writing date. Never ever you write your date like this.
Is it clear to you? So date either follow this pattern or this pattern you can follow. Even one thing I have to tell you, instead of writing complete year, you can write like this also. This is also accepted, double X, instead of writing the year. Is it clear? As far as sender's address is concerned, these are the particularities you have to maintain, children. Now, let's go ahead about addressing. Now I clear this area. Now we'll talk about addressing. Normally addressee is given. It is given whom to write the address. Here we see certain things. I can show you clearly what is to be done here. See, second part is addressee. Now, what precaution we should take? As you can see here, there should be two. Ha, one more thing. After writing sender's address, you write date, and after that, one line's blank should be left. Where? Here, there should be one line's blank. Remember, children, there should be one line's blank. That should not be entirely connected. Otherwise, that difference will not be identified, and that will create a very shabby figure of yours. So here you are maintaining blanks. Now, about addressee. Addressee means the one whom you are writing your address. Start with two. But here you see, you should not write any comma after two. This is wrong. Why wrong? This is a schedule. This is a ritual. Normally, after two, comma is not given. So do not give here comma. After two, you write the. Clear? And after that, whomsoever you are writing later, like the principal. Clear? Comma. Then the name of the school. Then the area. Enough. Don't write much here. Only thing is that when you are writing about addressee, two, and one thing you have to remember, entire thing must come in a straight line. As you can see here, you cannot write too much away from the margin, to the right hand side margin. Here you can see everything is quite close to margin. Is it clear? This much is clear.
Children, this is about addressing. We have to take certain particularities. We have to think about it, about addressee. Here you can see, as I told you, after two, do not place comma. Second, after that you write the, before the designation. And here, like if you are writing to the principal, so it will become the principal. Clear? Comma, then you write school's name, then city's name. This address should not be longer one. As you can see here, children, write close to your left hand side margin. You should not write too away from the left hand side margin. Otherwise, again, the symmetricality will be ruptured and that will not appear, means impressive. Remember that writing letter is just like drawing rangoli. So its first impression is very important. Now let's go ahead. Now we'll talk about the next. Here subject. Now see here subject, what should we write about subject? Certain things we have to remember about writing subject. First, start your subject with V4. You know what is V4? Present participle, means ing. When you are writing subject, write V4, like requesting for, complaining about, suggesting for, asking for, seeking permission for, forwarding the following requirement. So what I mean, you start your subject with V4. It should not be longer one, and end without full stop. Remember, like here, requesting for new books in the library. Correct? So requesting for the new books in the library, I write it here. You can see requesting for the new, etc., etc. But after that, there should not be full stop because it is not a sentence. At the end of your subject, there should not be full stop, and prefer starting your subject with V4 and ending without full stop. Is it clear now? Now, let's think about the opening salutation as you can see here. Now, we'll talk about the opening salutation here, this one. Clear? What precaution we should take while writing opening salutation? See children, there are various ways. If it is a personal letter, you simply write dear friend, dear mother, dear sister, dear brother. But when you are writing formal letter, there are various ways of writing opening salutation. There are some ways. First, see here we are discussing about this. Here you can write first, my dear sir, sir or ma'am, comma. Second, dear sir or ma'am. Third, respected sir, sir. Or fourth, merely you can write sir or ma'am. When should we write all these things? Pay attention to me very carefully. This is very crucial. When you are writing formal letter to person who is very closely associated to you, like your neighbor, like your friend, whom you are writing formal letter, remember. So that time you can use this, my dear Sachin sir, my dear Vikram sir, my dear Anil sir, whatever it may be. Then dear sir, this can be used to anybody. Dear sir, clear? The one whom you know, the one whom you know, but you are not very much closely associated to that person. The one who is not very close to you, that time you can use dear sir. Respected sir, the one whom you think should be given respect. The one who is really respected in the society, the one you sincerely think that person deserves to be called respected sir, that's your own choice, but I would not advise you to write respected sir every time. That's your own selection, that's your own jurisdiction. I should say, that's your own conscience where you are using respected sir. Normally you should write sir or ma'am, that is accepted. You do not go for unnecessarily detail. Do not write dear sir, do not write my dear sir or ma'am, do not write respected sir or respected ma'am. Simply you write here sir or ma'am, merely that is sufficient. So here you can select any of these four, but it's my suggestion that you should write only sir or ma'am, that is sufficient. Now, as you can see here, there is opening lines. Clear? Opening lines are there. I want to here, as you can see, this certain lines can be written as an opening lines. Why? Why should we write opening lines? There are some benefits of opening lines, children. See what benefits we have of writing opening lines. First, it gives a quick start. Second, saves your time. Third, avoids correction. What happens? I have seen children, these three benefits are there of writing impressive opening lines. What are the benefits of writing opening lines? First, don't forget, you are given only 12 minutes approximately, roughly, it's a rough calculation. Board does not give you any time barrier or time restrictions. Simply, you should have calculation that for 10 marks, roughly you have 12 minutes. In 12 minutes, you are supposed to write a letter which should fetch you 5 marks. So in that case, nothing should be written casually in your letter. Everything should be impressive. Moreover, I want to tell you, in formal letter, selection of words, selection of expressions should be very concise and should be very perfect. So in that case, why should we have one opening line? That gives a quick start. I have seen children, they are scribbling when they are about to start a letter. When they are about to start letter, they are scribbling. They are chewing their pen. They are thinking, and that kills their time. If you have ready-made opening line, that saves your time because your pen knows what to write. Your brain should not know. Your pen should know what to write. That gives a quick start. You write this address and everything, salutation, and immediately you start writing. Clear? It saves your time. Second thing, gives quick start, saves your time. Third, it avoids correction. Normally, children, I have seen, we have been evaluating your papers, and it is a common sight that children often commit lot of corrections when they are writing, they start writing the letter. Because they cannot understand, what should I write first? What should be your first letter? What should be my first line? And in that dilemmatic situation, we often commit mistakes. So to avoid these corrections, normally opening lines should be ready. In personal letter, there cannot be much variation in opening lines, but in formal letter, there might be variations for opening lines. For letter to editor, the opening lines will be different. Letter to the principal, opening lines will be different. For job application, your opening lines will be different. For leave application, your opening lines will be different. And for placing an order, for that also, opening lines will be different. And for formal letter, opening lines will be different. So, which kind of letters are there in formal letter? Letter as a social representative. Letter as an individual concern. These two kinds of letter are there normally in formal letter. So I give you one suitable opening lines here. You will see that. I give you here one suitable opening lines, and these opening lines can be applicable for maximum kinds of letter. So here, you should have one opening lines ready with you. Something about two or three lines. You keep your opening lines ready so that whenever you are writing letter in examination, you give it a quick start. Now we move to main body. Here we see main body of letter that carries the special importance. In this main body of letter, you have to put up your problem, your requirement, your complaint, your suggestion, whatever you want to say, that is to be put up in barely not more than 8 lines, remember. Because in formal letter, we should not write much. Actually, in letter, we should not write much. It's not essay writing. In letter, we have to be very precise and very up to the mark. So here, in main body, you have to elaborate your query, your concern, your question with suggestions. There you write in main body, and this is a part that depends upon the situation. Clear? So there you express your views properly, and remember that selection of words should be very official one. Clear? Use of sentences should be very perfect and up to the situation. Now we move ahead to the closing line. Again, this closing line, that also matters. Closing line also saves your time. Closing line also gives a quick end to your letter, and your pen knows what to write while closing. There should not be many closing lines. Closing lines can be two or three lines. Actually, it should be two lines only. Write only two lines when you are closing your letter. Now we go ahead to the closing salutation. Here, write thanking you, as you can see here. And after that, you give comma. Thanking you, you give comma. Then leave one line here. Children, I want to show you where you have to leave one line here. One line can be left here, one line here, one line. These are the places where a line's gap should be left. Because according to new pattern, we are expected to write in block writing pattern. You know what is block writing pattern? In block writing pattern, we are starting right from the margin. Means we are not leaving space from margin to the first letter of your write-up. Simply, we start writing from the margin. In paragraph pattern, so in paragraph writing pattern, as you can see here, in paragraph writing pattern, we are giving a gap between margin to the first letter of your word, as you can see here. This particular thing is to be noted very seriously. As you can see here, I have shown you the gaps. These blue lines with cross are showing one line gap. Offline, one line gap is shown here with these blue lines. So I was talking about block writing pattern and paragraph writing pattern. According to new directions of the board, we all are expected to write in block writing pattern. So these are the block writing pattern I have just told you recently. And in paragraph writing pattern, we are not leaving gap between two paragraphs. But in block writing pattern, we are leaving a complete gap of one line between two paragraphs. Is it clear to you? Now, let us talk about this. See, I have done a fair division of every segment of letter writing. First, sender's address. I have told you everything about sender's address. Second, your addressee, means the one whom you are writing address. Third, subject. I told you what precautions you are supposed to take to write an effective subject. Then opening salutation, that we have talked a lot about opening salutation. Then opening lines, I told you, keep your opening lines ready always. That saves your time, and I told you the benefits of writing opening lines. After opening line, there should be a gap of complete one line. Then there is main body, then there is closing line. And now we'll talk about this closing salutation. As you can see here clearly, as soon as your closing line gets over, you write here thanking you, not thank you. See the difference? Thanking you, not thank you. See, in letter writing, many things are brought down through tradition. There are traditions. You cannot ask why, sir, why can't I write thank you, and why can't I write that one? No, follow the system. There are variations. Often some instructions vary, as I told you about date writing. Writing of date may vary from place to place. Some of them give comma here, as you can see. Some of them do not give. But according to the modern conviction, comma is not expected here. Now, so as soon as your closing writing is over, you write here, right in the next line, you write your thank you. After that, you can give one line's gap, as I have indicated here with green pen. Then here, yours, after that I have left a blank, and here this blank is also left. This I'll tell you. Now here, I take it here. As you can see, what is to be done here? There are three ways of writing closing salutation. First, you can say, yours sincerely. Second, you can say, yours obediently. And third, yours faithfully. Three salutations are there normally. Three closing salutation we can have normally. Where to use them, that also you should know. When you are talking about yours sincerely, can be applicable to all. In all formal letters, you can write yours sincerely. But when you are writing yours obediently, that time, see that, prefer this. If you are writing letter to the principal, to your teacher, in that case, you should write yours obediently. And when you are writing letter to your owner or employer, that time you should use yours faithfully. Remember that. There is nothing written rule for that. But these are the modern convictions, these are the modern changes. Here you can see, you can write sincerely to anybody. If you are not able to select proper closing salutation on the 11th hour, you can simply go for yours sincerely. But here also, you should be careful about one thing. As you can see here, I have seen children often giving apostrophe here. This is wrong way. You cannot put apostrophe here. It will be plain like this as I have written. No apostrophe should be placed here. This should be capital. Although it may not appear capital now, but it should be capital. You should be capital, S should be capital after that comma. Is it clear? That is closing salutation. And what should be written after closing salutation? As you can see here, here again blank is given. Can you see? After closing salutation, there is a blank. In this blank, you can either write your name. Earlier, they used to write X, Y, Z. But now, you can write name, you can write your email address. But prefer to write your first name. Fake name, not necessary, you need not write real name. Real name and nothing real is expected anywhere in your letter. So here you can write your first name, or you can write your email address, or simply you can write here, as I can show you, yours sincerely, X, Y, Z. No full stop, no comma, no hyphen between X, Y, Z. Remember that very carefully. So children, I hope you must have enjoyed my video, and I hope you must have learned certain new things about letter writing. So keep on watching it. I too enjoyed interacting with you. I hope you all must be at your home. So stay home, stay safe, and just go on watching videos and go on enjoying the days as they are coming. Thank you very much, children. Bye.